This is insane and desperate, even for you.
Well, insanely desperate is where we are, don't you think, though?
Compound B?
That doesn't sound good, Ashley. Well, you know shit, actually. Sorry, Ashley.
I think if there's a way to screw this up, you'll find it.
Bees?
Welcome to Compound B, a show about the boys. I'm Jamie G, Esquire the Fifth, and my quasi-legal skills are as ferocious as a V'd-up chicken. I'm here to do some Compound B with my brothers Magnum Mills and the Soupdeucer. How you doing, Soup? Are you ready for the new season of The Boys? Have you been chasing chickens around, I don't know, like Rocky II for training? Or are you sticking to the 12-ounce curls?
You know, I'm doing the 12-ounce curls for sure, and I'm not really chasing chickens around, but I am, you know, breaking them down and cooking
choking them.
Yeah, a little choking them, a lot of eating them, a lot of cooking them, you know, and playing with my chickens, dude, you know.
Never come between a man and his chickens, and I'm Magnum Mills, and if I'm going to chase a chicken, I'm going to KFC or Popeye's, whichever is closest. So grab your chicken, maybe grab some bourbon, because this is the season four preview of The Boys from Compound B, presented by Regular Dudes Watch Stuff. You can find us wherever you get your pods and on YouTube, on social media, at Compound B Pod, at Dudes Watch Stuff, all over the place. Find us on the web at dudeswatchstuff.com. Thanks for remembering all that. And while you're at it, try not to forget the flaps. Follow, like, and please subscribe. Helps us out a ton. Please remember to hit the thumb. You need that weekly injection of the Compound B to stay at a peak power.
Before we go any further, you need to be aware that Compound B is 100% a full-on spoiler show. All episodes of The Boys, don't forget about Gen V, and the incredible Diabolical. It's all up for discussion, all episodes of all the above. We will avoid major spoilers from the comics, but minor spoilers, that won't impact the show. They're fair game, and we'll probably spill some of those. And if you don't know, now you know.
All right, let's get right into our season four preview, because I think we have a lot of ground to cover. I think up front, it's important to just start with what we're hoping for out of the season. I think it all goes without saying. We obviously love The Boys enough. We're sitting here. We're talking about it. We want it to just keep doing what they're doing, stay awesome. So let's just say kind of that's implied. Outside of that, what are you looking for out of the season? I'll start us off by saying I would like to get a little bit more kind of backstory out of Vought. I think that would be cool. I don't know if we need a whole like throwback episode to the founding, but you could always bring back kind of Stormfront. I think there would be some cool stuff there. I'd like to get some more behind the scenes, kind of how the sausage is made at Vought. I kind of like all the evil machinations that are going on, you know, bring Stan Edgar back onto the board, that kind of thing. So that's kind of one thing I'm hoping to see. How about y'all? What are you hoping to see? Soup, anything in particular you're hoping to see out of this season of The Boys?
You know, as far as like pinpointing something other than what they normally do, most importantly, I want to see them do what they normally do. And if they do that, then I'm going to be satisfied with it. I do like the backstory idea, and now that you mentioned that, I really like what they did with Black Noir in the last season. So maybe dive into one of the other main characters and kind of give like a whole segment or even episode devoted to that. You know, I think that would be very cool. No matter what character it is, I think it would be kind of clutch to have something like that in the mix. You know,
yeah, because it was cool with the change up too, right? Because it was animated stuff. It was almost like a little bit of taste of Diabolical in the show, even though I think at that point, I don't think Diabolical had, maybe Diabolical had come out, but it was just cool when we got those little animated sections when he kind of went in his head and with Busted Beaver and everything like that. You know, that was kind of one of the most kind of, The Boys is pretty crazy to begin with, but kind of bringing animation into live action like that, it was kind of wild, but I thought it really worked and I super enjoyed that. And Jamie G, our resident sommelier, what would you like to see this season of The Boys? What are you hoping for here outside of it just continuing to be awesome?
Jamie G, Esquire the Fifth, Sommelier Level 2. True story. I'm like Obi Trice, real name, no gimmicks. Mills, for me, I'm with Soup, man. I'd like to see some of the development outside of what we normally see, which is blood, murder, mayhem, and awesomeness that goes on with the characters of The Boys, with this incredible balance of comedy that's like literally genius. They're one of the best at creating this crazy murder, mayhem, violence, blood, but then like being hilarious. It's really special. One thing I do want to see outside of that, though, is the development of some of these side characters. They've been teasing Deep for a little bit. And then in the trailers, we got to see kind of a new Deep. I'm really excited about that, man. I kind of want to see where they go with like those type of characters. I think they've done so much with the boys and then like the Homelander of the world. And we, of course, want to see that. And we want to see like, you know, Love Sausage and all these randos come into the play here. But I want to see like, you know, like a Deep, for example, being developed. And the preview gives us hope that that might happen.
And also possibly a wine-based superhero. Maybe they can find one of those. I mean, you got to be this the super saiyan or something. There's got to be a like the gigantic Jeroboam or Jeff Jeroboam. I don't know. I'm just trying to come up with something.
Mills, the Bloody Bordeaux.
That's pretty good. Sounds more like a horror flick or a slasher, but we could be there for some kind of horror soup. And you kind of mentioned the blood, the mayhem, the death. I want everyone to give at least who you think is the most major character who might die this season. I'll go right back to you, Jamie. Did you give us a prediction of the biggest major death this season? You know, someone's got to go at least. I mean, don't cheat and go Todd. I mean, because we all want to see Todd bite us. Who else besides Todd?
I don't know that I'm ready for one of the boys, like, and I'm damn sure not ready for Frenchie's girl, like, hell no. I guess I'm ready for, like, I don't want to see Charlotte die either. This is hard, dude. This is hard because I really don't want to see anybody die. I know they have to die, but I really don't want
to. It's not if you want to or not.
Awesome. You guys go first. I need a minute.
I'll throw Dakota Bob out there. He's a Victoria Newman's running mate. I feel like the ultimate play for her is to take him off the board so she can be president. So I feel that could be a total thing. And if he's president of the United States when he dies, I think that's pretty major. So I'm going to go with Dakota Bob. Soup, you got one?
Yeah, man. I think one of the biggest shockers, and I wouldn't put it past him to do this, Ryan Butcher.
That was on my list, believe it or not. That's a good one. I like that.
Soup, I really like where you went right there. I really do. It, dude, honestly, with what I mentioned before, I hate to beat the same drum, but I'm going to. I think that, you know, we saw like Deep flashing like this whole like new Deep. He's great and you'd miss him, but like maybe Deep can die. Also, surprise. A spoiler, I'm throwing this out there. This is like plus like 4,000 odds. Stan Edgar.
Well, that'd be mean to bring Giancarlo Esposito back just to kill him. That would be kind of cruel. I would throw maybe if you want to get kind of dark with it too, with Huey's dad, maybe. They bring Simon Pegg back just to kill him off. I could kind of maybe see that a little bit. That would be it. That would definitely, you know, maybe get a little dark Huey. So then that makes him want to team up with Butcher more or kind of go more towards Butcher's way. Something like that. I mean, that's...
But Mills. One thing I want to tell you is I had a dream, and the dream was I played the Moyle at Love Sausage's circumcision.
And so I thought that was a two-man job. They saw down Redwoods, so it's like the two-man saw. I thought it would be probably one of those to do that, though. So if you did that by yourself, dude, you have enough reach. If you have a wingspan like that, man, you should even if you're like 5'4", you can make the NBA if you have a, you know, 12 or whatever, like an 18-foot wingspan or whatever you got there, dude. You got some
obviously
span
to you're really hoping to see a lot more Love Sausage, man, as you should.
The man loves his sausage. It must be the
being his model, dude. That's a big job.
So if you, well, you can call it
legitimately,
that.
Yeah, I think you could. You could charge double for that probably. But before we get into the square footage or yardage or whatever unit of measurement, how about the backstory stuff? Like I mentioned, wanting to get some Vaughn. Y'all mentioned kind of seeing Deep's backstory. What other backstory do you think we get or do you want to get? I think we might get some Butcher backstory kind of after what we got from his childhood. And that's how Jeffrey Dean Morgan's character comes into play because they know each other from, you know, when Butcher was in the army or whatever they have him in the show. What kind of backstory stuff do you think we're going to get here? What do you want to get?
I mean, I can never have enough Butcher backstory. You know, present time story or whatever. So
even
always...
it's alliteration, right? So it's perfect.
I'd like to see maybe a little Frenchie backstory, dude. You know, and that might be kind of cool. You know, he's definitely got some history there. So
yeah, he's in play because we've kind of seen most of Tomiko's backstory. We have a decent idea about Huey. I think it's more likely we get Huey's dad back than get more backstory. Jamie G, what do you think?
Two things. Number one, I'd really like to go deep with Victoria Newman's backstory. And I think this is an easy pathway to bring in Gen V and kind of merge these two storylines together, which would be so freaking rad. Would absolutely love that. I know it's weird, like watching him drink milk and whatever, but like, dude, more Homelander, man. Anthony Starr is awesome, dude. This is such a cool role for him. Big fan of everything he's done, but like, would love a little bit more a Homelander backstory, especially if something happens and they kill off Ryan Butcher. Like, what happens to him, and like, where does he go on like a deep, like inside his soul level? That would be very cool to see.
I would like both of those. I think the only problem is probably you won't get Anthony Starr if you get Homelander flashbacks. I'm imagining it's like him being raised in a lab as a kid. So you'd probably get a younger actor playing him. That's probably the only downside. Maybe you could get the first time he goes out as Homelander or something like that. They could probably do that with Anthony Starr. But I think other than that, you probably would have to go with the other actors. Newman is real cool. And that would be also be a good way to bring Stan Edgar back in, to bring her daughter back into the mix.
Yeah.
So I think both of those things are pretty cool. Do you think we will get anything else from any of the other members of the Seven as far as this? You know, you mentioned the Deep. Do we get any more out of A-Train, maybe?
The one that jumps out from emails and Soup, keep me honest here and jump in wherever you want. It's Starlight, right? Like, she's going to be the one that's kind of taking the edge and going a different route here. And she's going to be faced with like, all right, do I just do the superhero thing, or do I join the boys and be, you know, they, them on the boys? Like, I love that complex nature of her character. So for me, that's, I think it's going to be a lot about Starlight here and what she decides to do, which is going to be a pivotal point. Soup, anything to add there?
The only thing I can really add to that is I feel like if there is something that's going to be a continuous thing throughout the show kind of started with her as like, you know, right from the beginning, it was kind of like...
She was way into the Seven, yeah, basically. Yeah, we were introduced right to on, the Seven right through on, her dude. Eyes.
So I don't think that she'll be terminated or whatever, so to speak. Because the feel of it from the get-go is that she's the main character, and I don't really think that she is. But, and it's not even told like through her, you know, perspective or whatever. But I think the way it'll play out she's still going to be very heavily involved. And the way it's going right now, I think she is kind of with the boys, and I feel like she'll probably stick there, you know.
There's a lot of ways you can go. I don't know if we'll get a ton more backstory, because we got more of her backstory than kind of almost anybody else's in the first couple seasons with her mom and everything. And even in season three, some of the flashbacks and everything. So I don't know about the backstory, but she's obviously going to play a big role. I mean, you have the Homelanders and the Starlighters are kind of the two big factions. So she is, for better or worse, probably going to be the face of the boys. Just out of curiosity, do you think we get Huey's dad back? I brought it up before. Do you think we get Huey's dad, Starlight's mom, any of the parent, A-Train's brother, any of those kind of people back in the mix?
I think we get one of the extended family members, depending on which chord they want to strike with kind of the outside family and the storyline of that person, you know, dying or being caught up in some crazy shit. I think it's whatever chord they decide to strike, but I think no doubt we get one of them. Whether it's Huey's dad, whether it's Starlight's mom, whether it's A-Train's brother, whether it's, you know, whoever. I think no question get some of that.
One thing nobody has touched on yet is Mother's Milk. And I know with that they did dive into a backstory with him. I believe last season it was a good bit of it was a nice healthy
more
dope.
Home life than backstory. We got a little bit of backstory, yeah. But not like a ton, because definitely in the comics, again, minus one, but he's completely different backstory other than the fact that Butcher recruited him, basically. Other than that, they're not a ton of but similarities, so they could go a lot of different ways with it. My guess is we'll get more with him and his ex and his daughter, you know, especially if, you know, she's still with the Botan. I think we all want him to just go away, and hopefully, I hate to root for someone to die horribly, but I'd probably enjoy it.
If there's somebody to root for to die horribly,
Yeah, I mean, he's basically Hitler. Let's not lie. He's basically Hitler. How about the Gen V stuff? We saw Sam and Kate in the trailers. We've talked about this a little bit already, but we're rehashing a bit in case anyone didn't see that episode. How much of the Gen V crossover do you think we're going to get here? Will it be contained to one episode? Is it going to bleed into multiple episodes? What do you think, Sue?
I'd like to see it sprinkled in throughout the season, little bits here and there, you know, and I feel like that might be the... For me, I think that would be the best play. but they're going to do whatever they do. And I do think there will be some crossover. And, you know, I mean, I think it'd be really cool to get some kind of like, you know, explanation about maybe like shit, like history with the Woods, and are any of these characters from The Boys have any involvement in that, or were they, it was anybody there to know anything, you know, like, so shit like that. I think I wouldn't be surprised if something like that popped up, and I would like to see, you know, a bit of that, you know, kind of.
Yeah, I'd like them to integrate it more. I think more is better here because it's only two shows. There's not a lot of episodes. This isn't like the Marvel Universe where you're trying to hook up like 30 movies and 10 shows or whatever. It's pretty easy to integrate these. And, you know, honestly, probably we're not going to get more Gen V for a while. So I'd like to see some more involvement here. And it looks like the virus that was developed in Gen V is going to be a major plot line here. So it kind of makes sense to have them involved. So I don't want it to be just a cameo. I don't want the whole season to like revolve around them. I don't want them to necessarily be in every episode or anything. But if they, you know, show up in 2-3 episodes, I'd be perfectly happy with that. How about you, JDG? Any thoughts on the Gen V crossover?
Badly, no, because they're going to come back with another season. They may sprinkle something this season, but you won't even know what it is. The next season's the season where they start to branch out into the spinoffs. I don't see it happening in season 4.
Fair enough. All right. You heard me mention the big presidential campaign we have going on with Dakota Bob, Victoria Newman. Do you think that the election is going to be concluded before the end of the season? What do you think, JBG? Are we going to have a result of the election before season 4 ends?
As much as I want to be a rocket man and pack my bags pre-flight, I'm going to say no. I'm going to say it's going to carry on into season 5.
What do you think, Soup? We're going to get a resolution to the election plotline this season.
You know, I'll have to agree with Jamie G there, man. I don't think that we're going to get any resolution. I think we'll get dick teased a little bit, you know, and it'll probably, you know, it'll string us along into the next season for sure.
Push it to the limit, take it to the edge. We all know the metaphors. Do you think there's any chance the general public finds out that Victoria Newman is the quote unquote head popper this season?
Well, that's a possibility.
That would definitely throw the campaign into some ruckus, right? What do you think, JVG? Any chance that people find out she's the head popper?
I would love it because it would basically cause this great divide where they've kind of been building towards her side winning the great divide. So that would be really cool because it would balance it out. But I don't think it happens this season because I think it's the juice doesn't work the squeeze. They do that, then essentially I have to kill her off. I'm not so sure killing her off this season is the right thing. I think you get next season is when that starts to explode. So I'm going to say that's a push till season 5.
Fair enough. And one more right back to you, Jamie G. Do you think our team, the Boys, will try to influence the election one way or the other, knowing what they know about Victoria Newman?
100%, dude. Yeah. They're going
to
be
against
like,
her? You think they'll try to go push it against her?
Mills, I'm not going to say they're going to call Georgia and be like, I need you to find me some votes. But I think they're going to influence this thing quite a bit.
So if you go down to Aubrey's and you flash the I voted right way and whatnot, you get the blowy and the bourbon, right? Is that how it worked at Aubrey's? I forget how the...
Ava, baby, how are things on your end?
Oh, the girls are excited to practice their constitutional right to vote and to give a free hand job for every vote cast for our man Shelby.
They already gave out blowjobs to a couple boys. Napier was counting on the hall for him and convinced them to take the day off.
I'm not sure I ought to be listening to this.
All right, and I think one thing we probably don't want a lot of, but I have to ask the question, do you think we're going to get any relationship drama this season? We kind of had it between Annie and Huey in season 3. Do you think we're going to have to go through that season 4, be it Huey and Annie again, maybe Frenchie and Kimiko? I don't know. I don't want any relationship drama. I'm hoping we don't have any. What do you think, Soup? Are we going to stay free and clear here, or are we going to maybe have to deal with it a little bit?
I think that this show has done really good about not pushing that too hard, but just enough to where before it gets annoying and shitty, then they kind of pull out. If we do see any of that, I feel like they'll follow the same kind of pattern on that, man. I wouldn't be surprised if you see a little bit of something because there is possibility there for it, but I don't think they're going to really lean on it, you know? I don't think it'll be a major plot point or anything.
I think that's a good call. I think we might see a little bit between, like you said, like Mother's Milk and his kid and his ex, maybe. I could see a little bit of that, but maybe it's Brian Butcher. That's probably the main relationship, right? Like, between him and Homelander, and then maybe Butcher trying to get back in his good graces. I'd rather the focus be on that than some kind of like romantic whatnot.
Well, from what we understand out of what we've seen from the trailer, that there's probably most definitely going to be some of that.
Oh yeah, 100%. They've definitely been laying that track for a minute.
Let's throw a real fucking wild knuckleball out there, man. Something you hardly ever see and would nobody would expect. Let's get OG Ashley hooked up with somebody. I'm not saying banging someone in the bathroom kind of hooked up, like a serious, like, thing, you know, like, I mean, not that I want to see that, but that would be more interesting than some of the other options that would be out there just because it would be a sidewinder.
I want her to hook up with also Ashley because they can just be the Ashleys.
Dude, that's the play right there. I love it.
Ashley on Ashley, dude.
We're bringing Ashleys together. I mean, that's kind of the way to go. Any thoughts on the new suits? We see two in the trailer, Firecracker, Sister Sage. Firecracker kind of gives the one speech in the second trailer about how the Homelander is coming from the Starlighters or whatever. I think fine. I'm hoping that maybe, you know, a couple of these pop. Do you think we're going to get any additional surprise soups kind of? You know, we've seen these two. That's it. Every season we've generally gotten a few new soups. Do you think we're going to get any notable soups outside of these two that we've seen in the trailers?
I would not be totally shocked to see Soldier Boy return to make a cameo or something like that. But what I'm really looking forward to is the random soups that just you only see once and they do something fucked up and crazy and that's it. And that's all you need, you know?
Yeah, like unnamed soups. Like we saw kind of Red River and that kind of thing. And we do see the one in the trailer, the girl with the tentacles coming out of her mouth. I don't know. I don't think we're supposed to know who that is. That's kind of wild. And kind of what we saw, like the Patience, the Woods, and Gen V, that kind of thing. Definitely some random soups out there in the world. What do you think, Jamie G? We gonna get some random soup action, or are we just basically getting Firecracker and Sister Sage? Both good names and good costumes, other than that.
I think some of the most kind of like fun that the show has had is when they bring in these random soups that have like the weirdest, like not usable superpowers. I think that's so cool, and I'm a big fan of that. So if they bring that back, even for just like to make something else that's a small part of an episode better, then that's worth it to me. As far as like mainline story type characters that may have supernatural powers, I wouldn't be opposed to it, but I don't see it happening. But I'd be wrong on this, but like it would be cool if they brought in somebody like a legitimate player that has supernatural powers, and it's like a big influential piece in the story as it continues to like, you know, like the clock turns and it moves on. But like, I don't see it happening. It would be cool if they did, but I don't see it happening. But as far as like the little stuff, yeah, dude, bring it on.
How about Ryan Butcher? I mean, he's technically a soup. I think maybe the first actual natural born soup, maybe. How much of him do you think we're going to get? We see him in the trailer, like throwing a dude into a building. So obviously he's ready to take the step towards killing people. Like, how big of a featured player do you think he's going to be this season? I personally think he's probably going to be like pretty heavily into the season. So I'm hoping, you know, the younger actor can really handle it. What do you think, Soup? Under over Ryan Butcher, 6 episodes. We got 8 in the season, under over 6 episodes, Ryan Butcher.
Yeah, I think we get a very heavy dose of Ryan Butcher. And as I kind of like thought earlier, in theory, if they do decide to kill him off, it's very reminiscent of what they did in Gen V with Golden Boy. And even if they do kill him off, maybe we still see him in the show. So
yeah, I think he died like early in the season, and then, you know, that's what Butcher has on his mind the whole season or something like that. That would be pretty crazy.
So I think any way they play it out, is we're gonna get a heavy dose, man.
All right, Jamie G, what do you think? Ryan Butcher, 6 episodes, under, over, or just even super heavy action in a few? Or what do you think? Ryan Butcher action.
One thing, and I love what killing him off does to advance the storyline and just how far Homelander is willing to go. Because we've been like led to believe throughout the first seasons here that he's willing to go all the way. He's willing to do absolute crazy stuff, like keep his control and power, etc. If his son dies, he's willing to go even farther, and I think that's awesome. But they've too much to build up Ryan Butcher, so I don't think we see it this season. So just speaking logically here, playing poker against the show here, I think he stays. But it would be awesome if they killed him, just because that would take Homelander to another degree of crazy.
Yeah.
And that's something that's, I think everyone will be like, wow, that takes the show to another level.
Yeah, absolutely. That's a good point, dude. One quick question. If they do decide to kill off Ryan Butcher, who is going to be the Dice Man? Does Butcher do it himself? Like,
it's almost got to be an accident, right? Like somebody who doesn't know and it just kind of happens. And because I don't think Butcher could do it. And I don't think even Homelander would do it.
Right.
And he's so powerful, you know, it's got to be a weird situation. I don't even know how you kill him.
Right, right. So, yeah, not saying that it will happen or that, you know, like, again, in theory.
Yeah, I'd have to bet, like, for better or worse, like a satellite falls on him. I don't even know. Like, just something that happens, like, outside of anyone's control and then Butcher blaze Homelander for it or something like that, maybe.
How crazy would it be if he dies at Homelander's hand by accident?
Oh, yeah, like he's trying to trade him or something or whatever. And
no, he's trying to save him or fight somebody. And Ryan wants to step up and help his dad, but ends up in his crossfire and dies. That's a crazy thing.
That'd be pretty wild, dude. I think it would be certainly interesting, and it would, you know, be kind of right in the, you know, down the in the wheelhouse for the boys there. How about whoever's in Black Noir suit? Do you think we're going to get any explanation for that? And, will whoever he or she is survive the season? I at least kind of want to know. They have to at least get another suit in there, right? You can't put a regular dude in there, can you? You think we'll get any kind of answers to it, or they're just going to kind of tease us all season and just, oh, there's a guy in a suit. We'll figure it out at some point. Because he died at the end of season 3, obviously. He definitely dies, and then we see him in the trailer. So there's obviously someone in that suit. Do you think we're going to get any resolution? Like, will we see whoever it is unsuited throughout the season? Even just let me ask you that. Will we see Black Noir out of costume?
I think that if this is anything other than a flashback or something like that, then they have to, you know, because otherwise, what the fuck? He's just back now, you know? I mean, there's got to be something, you know? So unless it's something like from the past or whatever, and
yeah, it'd be tricky. I mean, because I think we saw him in 2 or 3 scenes, so they could do that, but I would be kind of surprised if they did. I just think it makes sense from a public relations standpoint, right? They don't want to lose another member of the 7 and have to explain away what happened. So,
maybe.
Black Noir is always covered up all the time. So if you were going to fake a guy, like, it's hard to fake like translucent. You need another person and go invisible. Black Noir, you just need a dude who can be in a suit who's roughly the same size.
Right, but it's got to be somebody that can do that kind of shit, you know?
Well, theoretically, I mean, for public appearances or whatever. But yeah, I mean, if he's really going to be on the team, he needs to be able to be super powered. But if it's just completely public relations, you might be able to fake it. Jamie G, I'm not
that
saying
might
you've
be, that might be the biggest question mark I have on this right now from the trailers, dude, honestly, man.
Jamie G, you know public relations. Do you think this is a chance this is all just a bluff by Valk, or do they put another real superpowered suit in Black Noir?
I think it's a little bit of a bluff, but I think it's a trick bluff. I think that they have like some sort of like secret thing that's going to happen that people will think it's Black Noir, but it is, but it isn't. That's a thing. I don't think it's going to be like a brand new, hey, I'm Jeremy and now I'm Black Noir. I think it's going to be like a kind of like a hidden thing. But so I think it's a classic Jamie G here, Mel. Thanks, a little bit of column A, a little bit of column B.
Actually, I'm pretty sure what you were describing was a triple cross, but that's fine. I mean, it's not like the dude who's trying to be Pope in South Park who does the double cross. I mean, that's really the good one. We can do what you got to do to get to the triple cross. And we talked about the new soups and everything. How about the old soups, the old characters? Who do you think might show up this season? Here are some options: Stan Edgar, Victoria Newman's daughter, the Legend, Love Sausage, Soldier Boy, the Deep's ex, Huey's dad, Annie's mom, Terror, that's Butcher's dog from the comics, Queen Maeve, and Todd. We've talked about them all to some degree. I think the two I want to show up the most are the Legend and Love Sausage. I think the one most likely to show up is either Huey's dad or Stan Edgar. What do you think, Soup? But who's showing up this season?
I'm going to go with Huey's dad because of Simon Pegg. And I think I heard that somewhere.
I'm cheating a little bit. I feel like that was written somewhere that he might be coming back this season. So might be a little bit of outside knowledge on that, but I think it also makes sense. You know, Huey's actual parents are involved in the books. Again, minor spoiler here, but I think that makes sense. Jamie G, who do you think might show up again in season 4?
I could see a flashback of the principal Indira from Gen V. I know she died in Gen V, but a flashback of her basically formulating the why she stood the way she stood in Gen V, I think that could be pretty cool just as another way to kind of tie the two together.
She did invent the virus, so that would have to be a bit of a flashback, but that would make some sense to see. So
flashback, I like that. For sure.
And are we getting the legend, dude, or love sausage? Are we getting one of my two there?
I'm down. I'd like to see
it. I know you're down, but are we getting that? The legend makes sense. He probably plays a little bit bigger role in the books than love sausage, but both certainly play a role in our valid options to come back. I'd love to see them both. I'm not really a huge Paul Rudd guy outside of Beverly Hills Cop, but he did great, I thought, with the legend. So I really enjoyed that season three.
Dude, the heart said yes. The mind says maybe.
Well, what does the sausage say?
What does the Clams Casino say? I mean, you can't get that. You don't get sausage in your Clams Casino generally. Yeah, I don't know how they order it up in New York or whatever. Is there kind of anything else on the seven? You know, we saw a deep A train in Black Noir in the trailer. We kind of already talked about them all to some degree. And what do you think is going on with Deep, right? Because I'm pretty sure we see him like actively eating seafood. And that was kind of a big point when he had to eat the Bull Timothy in season three. Do you think he's doing that to impress Homelander, or is he trying to like make himself tougher or something like that? What do you think, Jamie G? What's up with the Deep?
I think he's doing that to impress Homelander, to try to grab stature. No way he wants to munch a scallop. He wants to bang the scallop, make sweet love, have babies with the scallop, not eat the scallop. Magnum
Mills. Only doing it if Homelander's watching. If he's eating with Homelander, then he does.
I think he's eating with Homelander, and to impress him, he specifically orders seafood. Give me the seafood medley.
No surf and turf, just surf and surf.
Surf and surf.
What do you think, surf? Any soup? See, you got surf on the brain. Surf soup.
Soup and surf in USA.
I'm going to give an opposite here. I'm going to say kind of like how they say once people eat people, they develop a taste for it, you know, and then you got the hunger, the craving. You know, I think he ate the seafood, and now he's got the craving for the seafood, man, you know, so I think he's got a secret
cannibal, dude. I like
it. I'm just thinking about Charlie and Dennis Manhunters when Dee and Charlie think they ate human meat, and so
human meat guy.
They go to a morgue with a six pack of beer and a George Foreman grill.
Oh, the Jones crackhead, dude.
Oh, I mean, that's about as dark as almost anything on The Boys. Obviously, season three kind of ended in a weird spot for A-Train, where it was a Blue Hawk's heart, the dude he basically drugged to death, and now he's got his heart, and Ashley was like, oh, yeah. Do you think there's any chance that A-Train kind of turns against the Seven this season? What do you think, Jamie G? Any chance that A-Train kind of becomes a traitor and betrays the Seven?
Yes, I think A-Train could be the wild card here that could be recruited by The Boys to go against the Seven.
Given, you know, his history with Huey, that would certainly be interesting. I think he is probably the most interesting non-Homelander character of the Seven if he were to cross over to The Boys. What do you think, Soup? Any thoughts on A-Train? We talked about just about everyone else in the Seven.
Yeah, you know what? That's definitely a good point, dude. I would not be shocked if it did play out that way. You know, some of me wants to say maybe the Deep would be one to cross over just because of how much he gets bullied around and shit. But yeah, maybe he gets to a breaking point and is like, well, you know, decides to do that. But A-Train almost makes more sense. So you know, that's interesting, man. I'm with that.
Yeah, they try to make Deep look a little bit more menacing in the trailers, like he's punching file cabinets or whatever. But for the most part, it kind of feels like Flipper, right? Like the Deep's only useful if you get near water. So at least A-Train is useful on land. We need more water, I guess, if the Deep's going to be more involved.
The shit that we did see with him actually using his powers and stuff, you know, the little bits that we did get was very, very cool. So I'd love to see more of that. But again, you have to have the water.
For me, whether it's a fjord or a whatever, a canal or the tributary, you need a little bit of water.
Water.
And Jamie G, any thoughts on the Ashleys? We brought her up a little bit. Any thoughts on OG Ashley? Also, Ashley, are they both going to survive the season? Do they both still work for Vaughn? Any thoughts on the Ashleys?
OG Ashley will live forever.
Forever.
She is absolutely living. You can't have the show without OG Ashley. That's how much I love her. Also, Ashley, though, that's up for debate. I think they develop this even more. And I think she goes to places that she doesn't want to go to retain her position for whatever she thinks that it is, as it becomes valued, you know, devalued, basically valued less as Homelander makes his play towards total control. So I think we absolutely keep her. Also, Ashley, though, that's a coin flip.
I can see her getting sacrificed. I might even say at the end of the season, OG Ashley is the CEO of Vought. What do you think, Soup? Any Ashley predictions? Got some Ashley points?
Well, obviously, they're, you know, OG Ashley is going to be in probably every episode, I would imagine, you know, so a major character here. And I'm with you on this one. I don't think she's going anywhere, man. You know, they also Ashley, definitely an expendable character, but I also think that that it's like the sidekick that'll stick around. So,
and in the final trailer, we saw some beat up animals, including a chicken and what looked like a flying bear. Any predictions here? How did the animals get beat up? Intentional or accidental? What do you think, Jamie G?
You know, honestly, you could make a case for both ways. I'm going to say accidental because, like, if it was on purpose, like, whoever decided to V up a chicken's an idiot. They should have V'd up like a rhinoceros or a hippopotamus or like an elephant or something that could do like serious damage. So alligator, like shark. Like I'm going to say it's like by accident, but it's still super cool. I can't wait to see it. And no, this does not mean I'm endorsing any sort of animal abuse. I love animals and I don't even kill animals, but like I'm excited to see it in the show.
He just eats them. That's all. Just a shout out to the poor Oscar World. Soup, what do you think? Accidental or intentional? Veed up animals.
I want to mostly agree here and say it's probably like some kind of laboratory mishap or something, and then used to the advantage of, you know, hey, well, this happened, so let's, you know, see what we can do with it, kind of thing, you know.
I'll go to split the difference for once. They beat up a couple animals in the lab, but like one got out and started banging other animals. And so that's how it all happened. I will go with that. And we see a bear, we see a chicken. Other than those two, what animal would you most like to see V'd up? What do you think? So if you mentioned a couple, what animal would you just like to see get the V and just go crazy with superpowers?
Fucking duck-billed platypus.
How about yourself, JBG? What animal would you like to see beat up?
Boy, oh boy. Gosh, I mean, obviously, like something like a tortoise would be totally interesting. But I'm gonna go with the honey badger, dude. Like the honey badger isn't scared of nothing, bro. Like, want to see the honey badger?
I will go with two because of a caveat. If it just has to be a land animal, give me a kangaroo. I think a kangaroo could do all sorts of things. That could be super cool. But if you could pick like a seafaring animal that could fly or do things, a shark, dude. Imagine a V-dub shark that could like fly around and is not constrained by water or oxygen.
Bro, it's mega shark. It's mega.
Yeah. Maybe get the little arms going on. I don't know. But like if they have laser eyes. I mean, we're right there to Austin.
Terrifying.
Right? He wanted sharks with lasers. We can have sharks with laser eyes.
Lasers?
With freaking laser eyes. Can it get any better than that? Seriously. What do you think? Will this be a one episode thing with the V'd up animals, or could this come into play throughout the season, multiple episodes? What do you think, Sue? One off or more?
Yeah, I feel like it makes more sense to just have it as like a one episode, maybe into another one. But
it seems like the one in the trailer, right, where they go to that lab in the country or whatever at the farm, and that's kind of where it happens. At least that's what the trailers want us to believe. What do you think, Jamie G? We get the V'd up animals in just one joint or in multiples?
I believe it to be a one-off. I want it to be a full-blown storyline, but there's just too much good here to risk going down the road of souped up animals. Just too much other good shit to figure out first. So unfortunately for me, it'll just be a one-off, but it will be a cool one-off.
I think I'm probably going to side with y'all on that, honestly, because I don't know if the budget can handle having, you know what, there will be like one random animal that escapes and shows up in like a V'd up cat or chicken that's just randomly in a couple, but for the most part we'll get the bulk of the action in one. That is how you split the difference. And before I open it up to free-for-all predictions, I just have a couple of kind of specific questions about the show. Season 5 is on. It's happening. That being said, I have a couple questions for you. Soup, what do you think? Will season 5 be the final season? If not, how many more will it be?
I think it's very possible that season five could be the final season, man. I don't want to see that because I'd like, you know, I mean, any show that I really like, you never want to see them end. But at some point, they all have to. So I think five would probably be a good stopping point, depending on where we're at. So it's hard to tell. It's hard to say right now because I don't know, like, maybe after this season, I'll have a better, judgment or accurate, portrayal of what I want to see out of the next season and whether or not I feel like that's a good stopping point for it. But it really depends on how it plays out, man. It seems like a fair number, five seasons is pretty good. But I mean, a show like this, I'd like to see it do long haul and maybe even push 8 to 10,
I trust the creators. That's the main thing. I think, five seems about right. Six, I would buy that. If you told me they signed a final deal to go to 8, I would be a little bit worried, but I would trust that this team can, bring it home and then land the plane. Jimmy G, what do you think? Will season 5 be the end? If not, how long are they going?
Yeah, it will be. And it's going to be hard for everyone because it's one of the greatest shows on television right now in a time when there's not a ton of great stuff on television. So this is like, it's already like a in an echelon of itself. But then you factor in, there's not a Sopranos going on right now. There's not a ton of big shows going on right now. So this is in an echelon of itself. But I think 5 is where it is. And I think they try to continue Gen V. And try to get another, maybe 5 out of that spin-offs. One.
Yeah, there will be more spinoffs. So
I think 5 is I think that's it.
I kind of do too, but I wouldn't mind if it's 6. I think if it's past that, then you need to have a plan and I need to be, because we've already put a ticking clock on Butcher, right? Could he conceivably survive? If you want to do 7-8 seasons, they're going to have to take place over the next year, right? Because that's what the doctor told Butcher. Although it's a superhero show, right? You could maybe give him regular V and then he's a soup or something. I have no idea how that might work. And before, just free for all, whatever, let me just ask you, what will we get next? The Boys season 5? Gen V season 2? Diabolical season 2? The Boys Mexico season 1? Some other spinoff or prequel? Jamie G., what do you think we're getting first?
Sticking with Gen V season 2, I know that there was a death of a very prominent character that they were going to develop and play a significant role, but I'm going to stick with Gen V season 2.
Soup, what do you think we're getting next?
I think this whole, the Boys Mexico thing will probably take place after the Boys is completely done, kind of like, when Sons Anarchy ended and there was the buy-ins, I think that'll play out that way. So I don't think it's that one. I think probably another Diabolical could be more realistic to kind of fill the space in between maybe the next season of the Boys or the next season of Gen V. So I'll go with a Diabolical.
I like that because it seems like, I know there's a different animation styles, but now if Gen V is going to be delayed, that's something they might be able to squeeze in there, because even if it's just throwing out, 4 or 6 animated joints and only have to be, 10 minutes a piece, 20 minutes a piece or whatever, that seems kind of more feasible maybe. And I'd like to see more Diabolical, really enjoy that. So I will go that as well. Final question, nice. Jamie G, when will the first episode of season 5 of The Boys air?
I'm going to say April of 2026.
April of 2026. Soup, what do you think?
June 25.
He's saying a year.
I think they do a quick turnaround this time, man. Hoping for it anyway. So
June 25. I got no Price is Right style. It could be Christmas Day 2025.
Ooh, love that. Okay.
The Boys, it's literally Christmas. And then you cut the Butcher.
You're all fucking welcome.
Any other free-for-all predictions? Again, I've read the book, so I don't want to say too much. I would say that I would love to see another showing of the annual Herogasm. I don't think we'd get it. I'd love to see it. Do y'all have any random predictions, free for all, whatever you think, for season 4?
I do know this. If they do go to Herogasm again, Frenchie better fucking be there, because he was still pissed off about missing the last one, man.
He should be buried at Herogasm, I feel like. If he dies, the funeral should be at Herogasm.
I don't know, man. Aside from that,
we covered a lot of ground, so that's why it's a free for all. It's
like
to be something kind of specific.
A gathering of random characters. This is why I like Diabolical so much, just for those random kind of like off the wall fucking powers that aren't like, really.
We're gonna get one, I think, because we see, I think, Butcher and MM in one of the trailers or the teaser at some sort of convention. So I think we might actually get that. That could be cool. Jamie G, any kind of random free-for-all predictions?
Just that Compound B is still going, and we will be, and we'll be doing it, and we'll be keeping you posted on everything. Shout out to Compound B. It's truly awesome. Very cool, very cool. Mills, what is our release schedule for season four looking like? It'll be here before we know it.
Look, I'm not going to lie, the first week is going to be a hot mess, especially with House of the Dragon dropping their first episode like 48 hours after the boys dropped their first three. So week one aside, the goal will be to have our episode out every week sometime between Monday night and Tuesday morning. Don't hold us to it week one unless we get screeners. We'll still try for that. So please like and subscribe. That'll help us our case to get the various screeners. But yeah, hopefully, you know, Tuesday morning should be there.
Well, I can't wait for it. But next time, just please, for the love of God, can one of these shows just move back by a couple of weeks or something? I mean, for Christ's sakes, we would definitely appreciate it. And you know what? We appreciate you checking out our show, Compound B. Please hit us up in the comments or get at us on social media with your season four predictions, what you want to see. Give us all of it. My preference is you slide in these DMs. Give me a reason to respond as I'm sitting and scrolling. Mills, remind everyone where they can find us.
Shout out to Jamie G, who managed to say sitting and scrolling instead of shitting and scrolling, and that's tough when it comes to the pronunciation. Thank you for checking out Compound B, presented by Reagan the Dude's Watch Stuff. You can find us wherever you do pods and on YouTube, on social media at Compound B Pod, at Dude's Watch Stuff. Simple, easy to remember. Find us on the web at dudeswatchstuff.com. Again, so easy to remember, just like the flaps. Follow, like, and please subscribe. It's a half-decent acronym, but it's even better if you click the thumb, assuming you had the fun. And even if you didn't have fun, just click the thumb anyways. We super-duper appreciate it. I'm Magnum Mills. He's Damien G. That's Soupdeucer. And this is Ben, Compound B.
That's right. And being that this is the end of our Compound B episode, we got to tell you what the B stands for this week in Compound B. The B this week stands for...